So just by simply showing people what Adventism really means, it will change their perception about Christianity.
Je crois qu'ils ont tout simplement besoin d'un peu d'amour, un peu d'attention, de se sentir acceptés, appréciés, avoir sur eux un regard ouvert et attentionné, c'est tout.
Every city in Europe is now less and less interested in the religious field, in the religious area.
In a way, well, they're looking suspicious at us and we're saying, oh, okay, who are you? What do you want from us? Why did you come here?
Mais ce qui touche, en général, dès la première fois où ils viennent, c'est l'atmosphère.
The Euro-Africa Division of the Seventh-day Adventist Church has created a program called 1 Year for Christ. This initiative invites young people between the ages of 19 and 30 to give 1 year of their life to work for the church. These young people are then sent to work in areas where the church has little or no presence. The roles that the students fill are impossible to define. Some work at pre-church plants. Others do community service so people in the local community will have a better understanding of who Seventh-day Adventists are. In every place where young people are volunteering their time, a positive influence is being felt.
They try to work out a project to try to contact a university student in Geneva. That was the first step of this project of Le Lab.
Salive Adventist University, better known as Collonges, is tucked into the hills above Geneva, Switzerland. This beautiful mountain environment is one of the last places you would expect to find a cutting-edge project to reach young secular minds. Here, three Adventist young people are donating 1 year of their lives to reach out into a city where some 70% of the young people don't believe in God. The project is called Le Lab.
The lab means laboratory, which is a way of experimenting something, but it's also the name of the labyrinth, which is a path, a way to try to find a goal of something.
Using the resources of the theology department at Collonges, Le Lab has developed a program of trying to help young secular students understand who Jesus is and how he can play a role in their lives.
La plus grande récompense, c'est de voir les gens changer. C'est-à-dire de voir des gens qui au départ étaient un petit peu tristes ou qui ne s'ouvraient pas beaucoup et de petit à petit les voir de plus en plus s'ouvrir et avoir envie d'avoir une relation avec Dieu. Ça c'est la plus grande récompense quoi. Entendre quelqu'un qui a envie, qui est motivé, qui a soif de Dieu, c'est ce qu'il y a de plus beau vraiment dans un projet.
Fabian is the team leader for the Le Lab project. Each Wednesday night, the group meets in a rented cafe near the student quarter of Geneva. Between 30 and 40 young people come for a meal, a short presentation, and then a small group discussion of the evening's topic. Before the meeting even begins, Fabian and the other team members meet to pray for God's guidance in their project. Eloy is a team member from Spain. He's in charge of creating audio and visual tools to help convey the message of each week's topic. His creations often evoke an emotional response from the people.
El video, la música, todo que es multimedia es un medio muy muy potente y muy muy válido para llegar más allá que una más lejos que una simple reflexión. Llega mucho más en profundidad a la gente. A veces una foto con una música y un mensaje que va enlazado a todo el conjunto.
Sylvia is one of those who has been touched by the Le Lab. Her mother raised her as an Adventist, but she had little or no interest in the church until one day she realized that her life was missing something. Le Lab helped her find it. She says that through Le Lab, she learned to listen to God.
And he say, don't worry, just believe me and you can have a good life and just trust me, Sylvia, and I can change your life.
Emmy is the third member of the Le Lab team. She is the social coordinator and plays an important role in making everyone feel welcome. She also helps to lead out in the small group discussions. Emmy has only one goal.
Je crois ce que j'aimerais le plus, c'est de voir les gens qui viennent et qui vont encore venir, de grandir. Grandir dans le sens où ils s'épanouissent, ils se trouvent eux-mêmes et ils trouvent Dieu au fond de leur cœur.
As Le Lab grows, its leaders hope that a church can be planted in the next 2 years. Their dream is that people learning about Jesus today will help teach others about his love tomorrow.
I hope I can give them a message about Jesus, because too much people in the world have too much sadness, and some people have life very difficult. And I hope Jesus give me the power to forgive that one day. And that is the concept in the lab.
There's a new wind blowing in Romania. In a small town called Vinju Mare, Romanian for strong wind, here Seventh-day Adventist young people are changing perceptions, both their own and those of people they're reaching out to.
The people here mostly live off a couple of factories that are in the town, and agriculture. In this particular part of Romania, religion is not much related to God, but more to the culture.
The Seventh-day Adventist Church in Romania has selected 11 young people to work in this small town. Here, they perform simple tasks that touch the lives of people who live here. By living and working among the people, they are accomplishing great things in a town that hasn't been very accepting of the Adventist Church.
Ca tinerii care vor participa în acest proiect să fie legați întotdeauna de Iisus Hristos, de Mântuitorul lor, de viața bisericii și de misiunea de a salva pe cât mai mulți oameni pentru Dumnezeu.
The young people started doing simple things, like forming a kids club, tutoring students after school, putting on puppet shows, finding ways to make real connections with the community, to show them that Adventists are real people too. One way they could reach the young people of the town was through sports. Several volunteers asked if they could practice with the local soccer team. After spending time with the team members, they started to have a positive influence on them.
Mi-am dat seama că nu lucrurile bune care se întâmplă pe pământ sunt bune, ci și lucrurile spirituale care se întâmplă și încercările care le ai în viață.
The young Adventists in Vinju Mare have learned how to live, work, and fellowship together. This gives the group a combined strength that they then use to reach out to a community that at first was skeptical of their presence. They also find that group activities such as community outreach not only help them to grow as a team, but play a vital role in healing those who are most in need.
We do regular visits to the hospital a couple times a week. We have a few of us come, sometimes we all come on a Saturday afternoon, and just come and sing for them and open up the Bible. Here we can talk to them freely and openly.
The young people who have committed themselves to these projects find that they grew spiritually as much as those they are trying to reach. The One Year for Christ program not only inspires others with the story of Jesus, but it enriches the lives of church members who are involved.
Y ha sido muy bonito descubrir que yo he sido el primer evangelizado del proyecto.
Community outreach is one of many ways that the Adventist Church is telling the world about Jesus. Please pray for those who are volunteering around the world. For more information about Mission and the Tell the World program, please visit www.adventistmission.org.